When I'm traveling sometimes and somebody in a club will come and give me a CD, I've never heard of him or seen him before. It might be some kid who's made his first ever record in his bedroom. It might be good, bad, I don't know. But I have to listen to it because you do not know where the next good track is going to come from. So I listen to everything. I mean, I try to. I get, like every DJ, lots of music. And you have to go through it because you don't know who's doing something new or different. And when you hear it, you have to make, you know, you decide, is it something that you're into? And then if you like it, play it, why not? I don't just play music from people that I know or big labels. I play anything if it's good, from wherever, I don't care. If it sounds good, I play it. All music that you hear today, most especially dance music, it's sampled or the idea is taken from something else. So, I think that's already happening, but it's the way that you do it which is important. You can be clever and take an idea and change it and make it work in a new way, or you can take something and not do much to it, and it doesn't. You've just copied it, which is not good. You know, I think you have to be creative. It's okay to take things because everybody does, but you have to have an idea and be creative and do something with it. You know, develop it into something, and then make it yours. Not just copy somebody else's work and release it. Take it if you want, but do something with it. Change it and make it sound like something new. You know, that's important, I think. I know Sasha did it with Wavy Gravy. He put the parts of the track on the internet and let people take them and make different versions. I think it's a great idea. I don't think you would do it with everything, but you could do it with if you had an album, maybe you could choose a track and it would be a good promotion, publicity thing to do with the public, you know. You know, it's kind of to kind of get people talking about it and to give someone a chance as well, you know. Somebody at home can take a track, do something with it and send it back, and then if he likes it and he could release it, it's a good chance or opportunity for someone to have a go at remixing someone like this, Sasha or Rich Jordan, and maybe releasing a track, you know. And maybe nobody's ever heard of them before. It's very good. It's good opportunities, you know, for people who're starting. You know, it's fantastic.
Lying around the world, I'm too tired. Obviamente también nos podemos dar cuenta en el vinilo si tenemos uno o varios temas. Este vinilo en particular tiene un tema que abarca esta parte y otro pequeño, que viene así como de regalo, un bonus track, detrás. Vamos a ir a la parte final entonces del tema. Esta que estamos escuchando es la parte final del primer tema. Vemos que detrás hay un surco también que nos indica ahí, muy bien marcado, muy pero muy profundo. Ahí terminó el primer tema y ahora va a empezar el último o segundo tema. La duración promedio de los temas, bueno, varía. Hay discos que están grabados en velocidad de 45 revoluciones por minuto y velocidades de 33. Eso nos da a nosotros mayor calidad o menor calidad en sonido. Este disco está grabado en 45 revoluciones por minuto. Si yo lo pongo en 33, nos damos cuenta enseguida por el audio, va muchísimo más lento y obviamente esa no es la velocidad normal. La velocidad normal en este caso es 45. Hay vinilos que están grabados en 33 y tal vez pueden llegar a tener más cantidad de temas. Por lo general, los discos que están viniendo de música electrónica y demás, los temas musicales tienen alrededor de 7 minutos, 8 minutos, por lo general. En algún vinilo nos encontramos con un solo tema y en otro disco que tomemos a la misma velocidad, tal vez 33, tal vez 45, nos encontremos con dos temas. Eso quiere decir que el surco está más comprimido. Obviamente siempre el tramo entre el borde del disco y el borde final o papel va a ser prácticamente el mismo, pero al estar más comprimido el surco puede entrar más cantidad de temas.